आई वेलकम क्लास नाइन स्टूडेंट्स टू दिस सब्जेक्ट केमिस्ट्री चैप्टर ऑफ दिस केमिस्ट्री क्लास नाइन नेम इज पीरियोडिक टेबल बिन विनेदो एस्टूडेंटिस कोमरेंजमस एल कैपिटेलो दिला टेबल पीरियोडिका एन केमिकल लानोसोत्रोस वी विल ट्राई टू कवर दीज पॉइंट्स इन केमिस्ट्री पीरियोडिक टेबल चैप्टर. Students, as you know, that this is a stepping stone of your class 9 chemistry inorganic part. So, please pay attention to this chapter very carefully because you will need this chapter in class 10, class 11, class 12, and if you are planning to appear for medical or engineering examination, this will be a crucial chapter. There is a inorganic chemistry book or section which is specially regarded for medical and engineering examination as well as class 11 and 12. That will be around 800 page book. So, quickly we will go to periodic table. Let us minimize this window and students, let me show you the ultimate result. This is long form of periodic table and we will try to reach here. Students, please follow the mouse cursor which is colorfully painted. So, let's go to the introduction chapter. In periodic table chapter, the syllabus will be Dobrynner triad, Newland law of octave, Mendeleev contribution, modern periodic law and table, general ideas regarding Dobrynner triads, Newland's law, Mendeleev periodic law, discovery of atomic number, so and so, modern periodic table which comprises of 18 groups and 7 period, and last but not least, we will also see the alkali metal group 1, alkaline earth metal group 2, halogen group 17 and 0 group inert gases. So, students, let's start from the introduction portion. It is a human instinct to classify the things together. It means we want to keep similar things together and different things at different places. So, students, please pay attention. Scientists have started to discover elements, copper, iron were discovered. Then there were attempts to organize them serially. Now, students, please check here what were the reason of classification of elements. Now, first, it helps in studying the elements in organized manner. Second, it helps in correlating the property of elements. And third, defining the relationship of one element with another element. And in the beginning, scientists were attempting to segregate the elements known on the basis of their malleability, density, ductility and other physical factors, whether they are metal or non-metal. Now, these early classifications were not sufficient because the number of elements falling in a particular group were so large that it was not beneficial. Secondly, some of the characteristics being considered varying different conditions. Third, certain elements were there which shows metallic and non-metallic characters both. Students, you know regarding the metalloids. So, scientists were in search of a peculiar property. It was William Prout who discovered that atomic mass of element never differ and it could serve as the basis of satisfactory classification. First attempt was made by German scientist named J.W. Dobrynner. Now, he placed the three elements in a group. It means he made a group of three elements and the group of three were called triads. Now, these elements which were three in number were showing similar chemical property. Now, in fact, Dobrynner was first scientist to show the clear relationship between the property. Now, check this box. The atomic mass of middle element of the triad was approximately equal to the arithmetic mean, that is average of atomic mass of the two elements of the triad. Now, we can explain the Dobrynner law on the basis of following examples. Now, consider three elements. Students, please check this. Consider three elements, calcium, strontium, and barium. These elements have following similarity. All were metals, all make oxide, which were basic in nature, and all have valency 3. Now, Dobrynner placed them in a triad, that is group of 3. So, the atomic mass of calcium was 40, strontium was 88, and barium 137. So, mathematically, let us revise and devise the arithmetic mean. So, 137 plus 40 by 2, here which is given, equals 88.5, and strontium weight is 88. So, you can see this is 88 and this is 88.5. So, this is nearly same. Now, consider second element. Students, please pay attention to the cursor. Consider three elements, chlorine, bromine and iodine. Now, they were also triads because they all were non-metals. They all form acid and have a valency of 1. So, take the arithmetic mean. 127 plus 35.5 by 2 comes to 81.25. Now, this 81.25 is very close to 80, which was of bromine. So, these were also tried. But students, this rule was not very successful because it was applicable to a very few number of elements. So, we can see the reason for discarding the law of triad. Dobrynner failed to arrange all the elements known in the triad, and law did not fully apply within the same family. Like in the halogen family. Halogen family is group 17. First three member, fluorine, chlorine and bromine are there. Let us check the average, like 80 plus 19 by 2 is 49.5, which is very very far from 35.5. So this 49.5 was much more farther than the 35.5. So this Dobrynner rule was applicable to one or two groups only, not very much. It failed. So people started to think of a new law. Next law is Newland's law. John Newland was a lover of music, so he arranged the elements in the musical style, and he found that every eighth element has property similar to first, like we saw in the music. In English style music, we know do, re, me, fa, so, la, re. Now, in Hindi, we know sa, re, ga, ma, pa, dha, ni, sa. So, according to, you can see sa, re, ga, ma, pa, dha, ni, sa. Starting from sa and ending with sa. According to Newland's law of octave, when elements are arranged by increasing atomic mass, the property of every eighth element is a repetition of the property of the starting element. It means, if we consider this and go into this, we will get 7, we will get 8 here, but that 8 will be similar to this first. So, students, let us check the Newland law more further. Newland divides the element into horizontal row of 7 element known, like, and inert gas were not known, so he has only 7 group. Later inert gas were discovered by Ramsey and 8th group, that is 18th group, was established. So we will see good points of Newland classification. This system worked quite well for lighter elements. It relates the property of elements to their atomic mass. Third, for the first time it was shown that there is a distinct periodicity in the properties of element. Third point is very very important, and you will know about this third point in class 11. Newland in 1887 was honored by Royal Society of Great Britain, and he was presented Humphrey Davy Medal. Now, this rule was quite successful, but when elements were started to be discovered, this rule started to fail. This classification did not work with heavier elements. It means those elements which were beyond calcium, it means more than 20 atomic number, this rule failed. Newland adjusted two elements, cobalt and nickel, in the same slot. Now, these were placed in same column as fluorine and chlorine. But a student, cobalt, nickel, iron, they are actually metal, and fluorine, chlorine are not metal. So, these were a few rules that were prominent enough to discard the rule. So, students, scientists were trying to discover more good rules. Later, in 1869, one very very good rule came, and students, this rule is applicable now also. We are seeing this new periodic table. Let me show you this new periodic table. This periodic table is improvised version of Mendeleev table. So let us see. In 1869, Dmitry Ivanovich Mendeleev, a Russian chemist, arranged all 63 elements known at that time. Elements with similar property were put one after the other in same vertical column with blank space, which were expected the properties was disrupted. It means where property of element did not tally with property of elements placed above it. Now, based on this, he proposed his law, which is called Mendeleev periodic law. Students, please memorize this law. Physical and chemical properties of elements are periodic function of their atomic mass. Now, Mendeleev has published two tables. Mendeleev periodic table was published in a German journal in 1872. But student, you will learn about the second table in class 11, that after 20 years he published second table. So what is actually a periodic table? Periodic table is a chart of element prepared in such a way that elements with similar property occur in same vertical column. It is called periodic because elements with similar property occur at different fixed intervals, and it is called table because elements are arranged in a tabular form. Now let us see essential features of a Mendeleev periodic table. Mendeleev periodic table consists of groups and periods. Groups and periods, there were all 8 groups. It means group 1 to group 8, each of these group from 1 to 7 were divided into two subgroups. You can see there are two subgroups. Here you can see two subgroups. Now group 8 has no subgroup. Inert gases were not known at that time. All elements of a subgroup, it means of group 8 which has no subgroup, have similar property and so similar valency, which is equal to the group number for up to group number 4, or group number subtracted from 8 from group number 5 to 8. In a period, elements gradually change from metallic to non-metallic character, or from metallic character decreases as we move from left to right across the row. So Mendeleev table has some style also. He represented the R letter, and he used the R letter to represent the elements of a particular group. Hydride of any element of group 4 is written as RH4. For example, hydride of carbon is CH4, but he has written RH4. Oxide of any element of same group is RO2. Actually, this is CO2, but he used R for any element, so C is here replaced by R. Now, students, this is actually Mendeleev periodic table. You can see here. I will request you to please pause the video for 2-3 minutes and please check the position, because this is quite similar to the modern periodic table which is followed today. Now, we will see the merits and good points of Mendeleev periodic table. First is a grouping of element. He generalized the study of element then known to a study of mere 8 groups. Second point, he actually left the gaps for undiscovered element. In order to make sure that elements have similar property, fell in the same vertical group, Mendeleev left some groups in his periodic table. These gaps were left for subsequent inclusion of element which were not known at that time but later discovered. Prediction of properties of undiscovered elements. He predicted that, okay, I am leaving the gap, so there must be some element of that type. Now, he actually predicted the properties of some undiscovered element in 1871, which were discovered later. Now, for example, Eka silicon and Eka aluminium are two major examples. Let us see this Eka aluminium. Eka means one place below. It means Eka aluminium means the box which is one place below the aluminium box. Its atomic mass and atomic chemical properties were quite similar to the element gallium, which was discovered in 1876. Students, he predicted in 1871, and after 5 years, gallium was discovered. Now, let us say property of Eka silicon are properties of germanium. Eka silicon means one box below the silicon box. Let us compare the Eka aluminium production and gallium. Now, you can see the prediction is quite similar to actual. Atomic mass prediction 68, found to be 69. Density prediction 5.90, actual 5.91. Melting point low, this is also low. 302 Kelvin is nothing but 29 degree C. It means it will melt down in your hand. Valency 3. So Mendeleev was very accurate. Let us consider this Eka silicon, he predicted, and this is germanium, what actually was found. So atomic mass, he predicted 72, found 72.6, very similar. Density 5.5, it now found 5.3, very similar. Melting point high, this is 1231 K, this is very high. It actually correspond to more than 950 degree C. Valency 4. So we can compare that Mendeleev was very accurate. Next point is incorrect atomic mass corrected. So he was able to correct the value of atomic mass of gold and platinum by placing them in his table. Now there were some defects later discovered. First one is anomalous pair. So students, let's try to get the point what were actually the defects in Mendeleev periodic table. This is very easy point, so please pay attention to the mouse cursor. Mendeleev table has many good points, but there were some defects also. Let us see the first defect. First is anomalous pair. The following pairs of element does not follow Mendeleev principle, like argon atomic mass 39 precedes potassium with atomic mass 39.1. How? We will see. Cobalt atomic mass 58.9 precedes nickel with atomic mass 58.6. Now students, why this happen? Because in Mendeleev time, the concept of atomic mass was prominent, so he placed materials and elements according to atomic mass. He had nothing to do with atomic number, which was corrected here, you can see, by Moseley. We will see in a moment. Now let us see what was regarding the tellurium. Now tellurium with atomic mass 127.6 precedes iodine with atomic mass 126.9. This is actually correct. If you see why this happened, if you see with atomic mass concept, this is correct. But nowadays we follow atomic number, so it becomes incorrect. Second, position of isotopes. Isotopes and elements are atoms of element having similar chemical and chemical properties but different atomic mass. According to Mendeleev periodic law, isotopes and element must be given separate place because they have different atomic mass, but they were not assigned separate places. Third point is grouping of chemically similar and dissimilar elements. Now elements such as copper, silver bear no resemblance to group 1 alkali metals, but they have been put together. Fourth is separation of chemically similar elements. Now gold and platinum were placed in separate groups, but they have many similarity, and Mendeleev table also do not encourage or discuss the electronic arrangement, because electronic arrangement is based on atomic number. Position of hydrogen was also not clear by Mendeleev. This is also not clear by modern law, and the controversy is still going on. After some time, the atomic number was taken as a basis. How it happens, please see. In 1913, Moseley used anode of different metal in discharge tube and subjected them to attack by cathode ray. He found that when cathode ray struck anode of different metal, the wavelength of rays produced changes. The wavelength of these rays were found to decrease in a regular manner on changing the metal of anode in increasing order of their periodic table. By this, he concluded that the number of positive charge present in the nucleus is actually the fundamental property of atom. Now let us see this box which is on your screen left hand side. The number of unit positive charge present in nucleus of an atom of a particular element is called atomic number of that element, and some of the positive charge present in nucleus is due to proton, and the number of proton is equal to number of atomic number of that element. Thus Henry Moseley found atomic number is a better fundamental property as compared to atomic mass. Now modern periodic law, which was given by Henry Moseley, can be defined as follow. Physical and chemical properties of elements are periodic function of their atomic mass. If elements are arranged in order of their increasing atomic number, those with similar property are repeated after regular interval. It means the periodicity of periodic elements is based on atomic number. Now let us see the explanation of this anomaly. First, position of isotopes. Since all the isotopes have same atomic number, they can be placed together in a periodic table. Position of anomalous pair. The atomic number of argon is 18, mass is 40. Similarly, atomic number of potassium is 19, mass is 39. Now, we are not getting this 40 and 39 because they were atomic mass. We are going at this 18 and 19. So, we can say 18 will be placed before that 19. So, we have placed argon before the potassium. In a similar way, the position of cobalt and nickel are also justified. Hence, Henri Moseley eradicated many differences and controversy produced by Mendeleev. Students, let us go to the modern periodic table. In last few pages, we have seen the Dobrynner, the Braut, the Mendeleev periodic table and law. The next one based on the Moseley is modern periodic table. When elements are arranged according to increasing atomic number, those having an equal number of valence electrons occur at regular interval or periods. Since the number of valence electrons of elements show periodicity, the chemical properties also correspond to the periodicity. Consider a group of periods of elements, like just consider first group element. Students, let me show you the first group elements. You can see here, follow the mouse cursor, this is actually first group element. This is actually first group element. You can see here, this is first group element. So, let us go to the page. They have a following common property. They have the atomic number 3, 11, 19, 37, 55 and 87. They all are good reducing agent. They form unipositive ion. Unipositive means plus 1. They are very soft metal. They are very reactive. They impart color when burning. They form hydride with hydrogen and they form basic oxide with oxygen. These are property common to all. And last but not least, this property, they all react with water to form metallic hydroxide, which is base. Now, all these elements have one electron in their outermost shell, so they have similar property. It is noticed that elements with a similar configuration have a similar property. So property that is repeated after irregular interval, it means they show gradual variation. Now, what is the cause of periodicity is a recurrence. Now let us see, if you can go through the electronic configuration of these atomic number, if you write the atomic configuration, you will see that there is one element in outermost shell. In a particular group, the number of electrons in the outermost orbit remains the same. It means the electronic configuration remains the same. So, valency also remains the same. So, elements of these groups have similar property, though number of shells can increase or decrease. This is the table we will be seeing, and students, I will show you the periodic table many times during the chapter. So, please pay attention. Now, going on to this point, silent feature of a modern periodic table. The vertical columns in the periodic table are called groups. Horizontal row are called periods. Let us see something about the group. Students, please pay attention to the left hand side of your screen. The modern periodic table has 18 vertical columns. Let me show you another figure of vertical columns. You can see here, follow the mouse cursor, 17 and this is 18. So these are 18 columns and you can follow, there are 7 periods also. So let us go to the book. So modern periodic table had 18 vertical columns comprising of group 1 to 8 and 0. Now group 1 to 7 are divided into subgroups, so total there are 18 groups. Elements of subgroup A, it means 1A, 2A, 3A, 4A, 5A, 6A, 7A are known as main group or representative element or normal element. Elements of group 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 are called transition element because they have two outermost shell incomplete. Elements of 0 group, that is group number 8 or group number 18, are called inert gas or noble gas because owing to their stable electronic configuration, they hardly react with any other element. Next point is period. you can see, we have seen that there are 7 horizontal rows in the modern periodic table. Each is called a period. Let me show you the period again. You can follow the mouse cursor. This is actually 7 periods. This means first period, second period, third period, fourth period, so on. This is actually 7th period. You can see this is actually 7th period. So follow the mouse cursor. Elements with their electrons increasingly arithmetic in outermost shell, one by one till octet is attained, are placed in same period. The last element of each period has 8 electrons except the helium. First period contains 2 elements only. It is called shortest period. Second and third period contains 8 elements, atomic number 3 to 10, and second is atomic number 11 to 18. These are also called short period. The fourth and fifth period contains 18 elements, that is 19 to 36, 37 to 54 in fifth period. They are called long period. The sixth period contains 32 elements. It is also called the longest period. Now, students, please check this point number 6. The seventh period contains 32 elements. It is called longest period. In group 3B, group number 3 of the 6th period, there is a set of elements with atomic number 57 to 71, beginning with lanthanum. These are called lanthanides. In group 3B, there is a set of elements with atomic number 89 to 103, beginning with actinium. These elements are called actinide. Lanthanide and actinide have similar property because they belong to same group. Group 3B, but they are shown at the bottom of periodic table because they are large in number, and showing them in main body of table will distort the shape of periodic table, but they remains the same and they belongs to same period, period number 6 and 7. Now, there are many types of element and they can be classified into 4 groups. First are representative element, second is transition element, third is inner transition element, fourth is inert gas or noble gas. Classification according to SPDF blocks is based on electronic configuration, which you will study in higher classes. This will start in class 11 itself. Now, students, please pay attention to point number 5.7.1, representative element. That are called S and P block elements which have their outermost shell incomplete. They include all elements of group 1A that are alkali metal. They form a strong alkali with water. Group 2, alkaline earth metal, form weaker alkali compared to 1A group element. Group 13, that are boron family. Boron is the first member of the family. Group 14 is carbon family, carbon being the first member of the family. Let me show you the figure. You can see this is group 13, boron is the first. This is group 14, you can compare, carbon is the second. This is group 15. Nitrogen is the first, and this is group 16, that is oxygen is first. Now, group 17 elements are also called halogens because they are generally salt producers. Chlorine, fluorine, bromine, iodine also falls in group 17 elements. The alkali metals are most inactive metals that occur. They are very soft and they produce base. The base is highly soluble in water, so these are called alkali metal. Main characteristics of representative elements are as follow. We will see 5 properties of representative elements. They include both metal and non-metal. There is a regular gradation from metallic to non-metallic character as we go from left to right across the period. They form electrovalent as well as covalent compound with non-metal. Metallic nature increases moving down any of the 7 groups. Metals which are good conductor of heat and electricity are present in group 1, 2. Non-metal which are present in group 16 and 17 are poor conductor of heat and electricity. Some heavier elements like tin and lead exhibit variable valency. And regarding variable valency, we have covered that point in last chapter and class 8 also. Let us see some transition element. They are included in group number 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. And the main properties of transition elements are as follow. All these elements are metal with very high melting and boiling point. they are very good conductor of heat and electricity. Some of these elements are attracted to our magnet. Most of these elements are used as catalyst in chemical reaction. Most of these elements exhibit variable valency. Most of these elements form colored ion and colored compound. Let us see inner transition elements. Students, let me show you the figure once again. These are the groups we have seen, and we have also covered these are representative elements, and these are transition elements. You can see these groups are transition elements. These are representative elements. Let us see the inner transition element, and we will come back to this figure once again. Now, elements of 6th and 7th period of group 3, lanthanide and actinides, are collectively known as inner transition elements. Main properties of inner transition elements are as follow. They are very heavy metals with very high melting and boiling point. They show variable valency. They form colored ion. Actinides are all radioactive elements. Some of them are not found in nature. They are especially manufactured in laboratory. Now, students, let us check some properties of inert gas, that is group number 18. Elements of zero group, which are 18th group elements, are called noble gas or inert gas. They barely react with each other or any other elements. Now, we will see the bridge elements. Elements of second period resembles in property of element with next group, that is called bridge element. Students, you can see here. Let me show you the figure. This is group 1, this is group 2. This is actually called diagonal relationship. Group 1 lithium has property similar to group 2 magnesium. You can see the diagonal. Group 2 beryllium has the property similar to aluminium. This is called bridge element. This is also called diagonal relationship. Now, there are typical elements. The third period elements like sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus and chlorine summarize the property of their groups, so they are actually called typical elements. We will see merits of modern periodic table. First one is it is based on atomic number, which is even better fundamental property as compared to atomic mass. Number two, position of element in the table is related to its electronic configuration. Number 3, it shows regular change in property of element on moving across the period. Number 4, modern periodic table is easier to remember and understand and easy to reproduce. It means it is very very good, and you will get more of it when you go in next classes. Students, we will go to the defects of modern periodic table. Now, modern periodic table is very good. Actually, see here. Modern periodic table is very good, but it has some defects also. Now, first defect, position of hydrogen is still not satisfactory. As its properties are related to group 1 and group 17 both. How? In group 1, we have metals which can lose electron. Hydrogen can also lose electron. In group 17, we have halogens, they can gain electron, halogen can gain electron, similarly, hydrogen also gain electron. Point number 2, it fails to accommodate the inner transition element, that is lanthanide and actinide, into main body of the periodic table. Regarding this point, you will study more in class 11. Students, we will go to general trends in modern periodic table. Now, this is 90% applicable to all the elements, all the groups, all the periods. So, let us go to the group. Now, number of shells and valency shells. Electrons. Number of shells increases arithmetically, and the number of valency electron remains equal to the number of group to which the element belong. Also, the number of electrons cells in a given element is equal to the period to which it belongs. Like, just for example, take us this halogen. Now, halogen are in group number 17. You can see here, these are halogens. Fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, these are actually halogens. Now, Number of shells, how it is determined? Please check their electronic configuration. Now fluorine is actually 9. 9 is written as 2,7. Now 1 and 2. So this is number 2. Chlorine atomic number is 17. 17 is written as 2,8,7. Now this is 1, 2, 3. So this is 3. So students, how we can know the number of shells? We have to know the atomic number and we have to write electronic configuration. And electronic configuration is written, then we can easily find the group or period. Next point is valency. Valency of an element is equal to the number of electrons present in its outermost shell. Since element of a particular group have equal number of electrons in their last shell, so valency of all the elements in a given group is the same. Like this is group 1, so this is lithium, sodium and potassium. Lithium atomic number is 3, 2,1 is 3, so 1. Sodium atomic number is 11, it is written as 2,8,1. Please add 2 plus 8 plus 1 is 11. This is 1, so it is also 1. So we can summarize that valency of group 1A element is 1, 2A is 2, 3A is 3, 4A is 4, 5 is 3. How it comes 3? Students, we have discussed in class. After 4, it becomes 8 minus N. So if here is 5, so 8 minus 5 is 3. Similarly, this is 6. So 8 minus 6 is 2. Here is 7. So 8 minus 7 is 1. And for 8, 8 minus 8 is 0. So these are very easy points. Students, we have to memorize and revise. Now, properties of element. Element in a given group possesses similar electronic configuration. So they have similar physical and chemical property. Now students, there is a difference between equal and similar. Equal is a different thing, and similar means not equals, very nearly equals. So students, please pay attention to these points. Similarly, we can check another example. Like alkali metal of group 1, they are very reactive. It means their property are also similar. So in this way, reactivity increases. It means if you go down the group, their reactivity increases. Halogen atoms are also very reactive, but there is a decrease of reactivity. It means as you go down the group, their reactivity decreases. So these are metals, these are non-metals behaving just opposite. Now next point is atomic size. As we go down the group, atomic size increases. Why? You can see in the figure. Now lithium, sodium, all are given. Please pay attention, there is only 2 shells, so size is smaller. In potassium there is 4 shells, so size is bigger. Now we can see there is a cesium. Cesium has 6 cells, so cesium size is biggest. Next point is metallic character. So students, if you go down the group, metallic character increases. Students, you have to memorize this, and this will also be applicable for you in class 10. So metallic character increases as we move down the group. Let us consider an example of group number 15. Now there are nitrogen and phosphorus. They are non-metal, but as we go down to bismuth, we will see this is metal. It is on account of gradual increase in metallic character of element from top to bottom that oxide of element becomes increasingly basic. It means the lower in the group order elements have highly basic character. Now let us see the example. Above example we have seen. You can see here they are non-metal, nitrogen and phosphorus, their oxides are here. nitrogen and phosphorus oxide. Similarly, this is bismuth, Bi is bismuth, and its oxide is here. We see that these oxides are acidic, but this is basic. If you compare NO2 and bismuth oxide, then we can say bismuth oxide is highly basic in comparison to nitrogen dioxide. Now, hydrogen has been placed at the top of the group, above alkali metal of the group, because electronic configuration of hydrogen is similar to that of alkali metal, but both hydrogen and alkali metal have one electron. Hydrogen atom is very smaller in size, therefore many of its properties are different from those of alkali metal. As such, the alkali metal of group 1, hydrogen, is ignored. However, in some periodic table, hydrogen is not placed in any group. It is treated as a very special element and thus placed alone at the head of the periodic table. So, students, this was the discussion regarding the group. Let us come to the period. Now, number of cells. On moving from left to right, the cells number remains the same. You can see here, this is a typical third period. This is third period. Students, you have to check the periodic table, which I have also provided. This is third period, and you can see here they are actually their atomic number. You can see 1, 2, 3. This is also 3. 1, 2, 3. So, on moving left to right in a given period, the number of cells remains the same. Number 2, number of electrons in valency cell. So, it increases from left to right. Valency of element with respect to hydrogen increases arithmetically from 1 to 4 and back to 0. Why? Because 1 to 4, it goes on increasing, and after that we apply the formula 8 minus n. So, 5 means 8 minus 5 equals 3, 6 means 8 minus 6 equals 2. Now, but the valency of elements with respect to oxygen increases from 1 to 7. You can see this is 1, this is 2, this is 4, this is 6, this is 7. So, students, you have to memorize and understand these points. Next point is size of atom. Size of atom decreases. Students, please pay attention. Size of atom decreases when we move from left to right in a period. Why? Because number of cells remains the same. Students, please check. Number of cells remains same in the period. But number of electron proton increases. It results in attraction pull. So, size decreases. Properties of element. Properties of element depend upon the number of electrons in its outermost shell. So, reactivity first decreases, then increases. Metallic character. On moving from left to right in a given period, metallic character decreases. Students, we have checked this on last page also. Let us check the elements of second period. These are actually second period elements. So, there are metals, there are non-metals. So, we can say metallic character gradually decreases. Metallic character gradually decreases and non-metallic character gradually increases. Now, oxides of element. Oxides of element in a particular group becomes less basic or highly acidic and finally changes to acidic character. Let us compare the example of third period. You can see sodium oxide is basic, but chlorine oxide is acidic. These are very easy points.